The latest on that massive Hollywood hacking crime. Provocative photos of some of the biggest stars, such as Jennifer Lawrence, Kirsten Dunst, and Kate Upton, stolen and posted online. The FBI is now investigating, and ABC's Rebecca Jarvis has that story for us.
From Jennifer Lawrence to Kate Upton, this morning the FBI says it is actively investigating what could be the largest hack of racy celebrity photos in history. More than 100 starlets allegedly targeted by a user calling himself Blunt Mastermind, who apparently posted the private pictures to the website 4chan.
This is a flagrant violation of privacy, a spokesperson for Lawrence said. The authorities have been contacted and will prosecute anyone who posts the stolen photos of Jennifer Lawrence. A representative for Upton also confirming the authenticity of the pictures and promising legal action.
Others, including Ariana Grande, Victoria Justice, and Olympic gymnast Michaela Maroney, calling their pictures fakes. Either way, the alleged hack is raising major security concerns, and not just for celebrities. It appears at least some of the material came from some sort of cloud, that is, servers which store all of our data, from our emails to our pictures. If you use services like Dropbox, Google, Apple, or Facebook, your data is in the cloud.
Even if you have deleted photos from your phone, oftentimes they've already been uploaded to the cloud.
Well, if you have a picture you don't want anybody to see ever, you probably shouldn't take it to begin with.
It's not clear how the celebrity photos were leaked, but Apple tells ABC News it is investigating whether any of its systems were compromised. We take user privacy very seriously and are actively investigating this report.
So how can you protect your own photos and information on the internet? Use unique and separate passwords for all your accounts. Enable two-step verification on all your apps. First, your username and password, then a randomly generated private code typically sent to your smartphone via text message. And be sure you accept those software update notifications. They arm your smartphone with the latest security protection.
Sources close to the matter telling me this morning they believe this hack was not into Apple's iCloud, which has some of the strongest safety protections available, but into another cloud storage provider, also offering this warning to anyone trying to search for those celebrity pictures online this morning. Hackers are already exploiting the issue, and they are posting fake links that claim to take you right to the pics, but instead they are taking you straight to a virus that you download onto your computer or onto your phone, Robin.
They're not wasting any time with that, are they, Rebecca? All right, thank you. We're going to bring in ABC's chief legal affairs anchor, Dan Abrams. A lot of attention on this case, but oftentimes when this happens, there's no prosecution.
Yeah.
Will it be different this time?
Look, there's no question that the law is behind the technology on this, but there are a whole host of potential crimes here. You're talking about the possibility of identity theft, wiretapping, unauthorized access to a computer. Remember in 2012, there was a case where someone had improperly and illegally accessed the emails of Scarlett Johansson and Christina Aguilera. He's serving 10 years. So this is serious stuff when it comes to the law.
How about those celebrities who have said these photos are fake? They're not really us.
Well, that immediately takes them out of both the criminal and civil realm, right? Because there'll be some people who will say, I want to sue, etc. Anyone who's saying it's not me is immediately going to be saying, in effect, I'm not going to be part of this case because, as far as I'm concerned, these aren't pictures of me.
You've said that the hackers are in deep trouble here.
Yeah.
How about the websites that post these photos?
There are protections in the law that protect websites from information that individuals post on them. But the individuals who are now, there are some individuals who are going out and reposting some of these photos, they're getting in trouble from places like Twitter, et cetera. And they could certainly theoretically be sued at a later time, but I don't think that's likely. I think the focus is going to be on the person who committed this offense.
Probably so. All right, Dan, good to see you.
Thank you.